Hello students, welcome to electronics class. In the last session we have studied how RC section is going to produce a phase shift, right? In that capacitor, voltage across the capacitor is lagging behind the voltage across the resistor. So by that the output voltage leads the input voltage by 90 degrees, that we have studied. See here, R value is adjusted in such a way that it should produce 60 degree phase shift at each RC section. Right? We had a formula that tan phi is equal to XC by R. When R is equal to 0, then what is the value? Then when R is equal to 0, then VI will be V naught leads VI by 90 degrees. When R is equal to infinity, then phi is equal to 0. Right? So what we have by in between these two, if R is set between these two values, some finite value, R is set in such a way that in this RC section should produce the phase shift of 60 degrees. So that means the RC section produces a phase shift of less than 90 degrees. That is, V naught leads the V in by less than 90 degrees phase angle. So that means if the R value is adjusted so that each RC section produces a 60 degree phase shift, then at the output will get 180 degree phase shift by this RC section. And this RC, 3 RC section is employed in the feedback path of the phase shift oscillator. So here operational amplifier, inverting operational amplifier circuit is used for as a amplification device. Which produces the 180 degree phase shift. The output is 180 degree out of phase by the input, and the RC section, this RC section which is used in the feedback path, which is going to produce 180 degree phase shift. Right? So total of 360 degree phase shift is obtained, which is the condition for sustained oscillations. Okay. So, the circuit diagram for the phase shift oscillator is shown, which uses the inverting operational amplifier, which as an amplification device, and the three RC sections are employed in the feedback network. So, the inverting amplifier produces the 180 degree phase shift, and the RC network, which is employed in the feedback network, is going to produce 180 degree phase shift. Total of 360 degree phase shift is obtained, and the another condition should be A beta is equal to 1. So it is already derived that A is equal to RF by RIN is equal to 29, and beta should be equal to 1 by 29. Okay, so then we'll get A beta is equal to 1, and we'll get the satisfy the standard condition for sustained oscillations. And one more thing, the frequency of oscillation, which is already derived in FET, that is 2 pi into root 6 RC. This derivation is not for your syllabus, so not required to learn. So only you need to remember the expression for frequency, that is 1 by 2 pi into root 6 RC. And the gain is 29, and feedback factor is 1 by 29. Okay. Let us solve some problems on phase shift oscillator. first problem. An RC phase shift oscillator has R1 is equal to R2, R is equal to 10 kilo ohm and C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to R3 is equal to R is equal to 10 kilo ohm and C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C is equal to 0.07 microfarad. Calculate the frequency of oscillations. So, solution, direct formula you have, F is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root 6 RC. This can be simplified as 0.065 divided by RC. If you substitute the values for pi, F is equal to 0.065, R is 10 kilo, 10 into 10 to the power plus 3. Into C is 0.047 into 10 to the power of minus 6. If you simplify using calculator, you will get 138.3 kilohertz. The oscillator, the phase shift oscillator is going to produce the oscillations at this frequency if the R value is set for 10 kilo ohm and C value is set for this one. By varying these values, we can change the frequency of oscillations. If you, whatever be the your desired frequency, you want to get the oscillations. I want to get the oscillations at somewhere around 150 hertz or 1 kilohertz. So, you can set the values for this R and C. Then, the frequency of oscillations can be changed to your desired frequency. Take down the next problem. What should be the capacitance of the capacitor required for the phase shift of frequency 120 Hz if the resistor has a value of 220 ohm? Phase shift oscillator of frequency. Let's collect that. Okay, solutions, F is given 120 Hz, R is given 220 ohm, so we have the formula, we need to find out the value of C, 1 by 2 pi into root 6 RC, so C we have to find out, 1 by 2 pi root 6 F into R, C is equal to 2 into 3.142 into root 6, F is 120, R is 220. So, C value after calculating you get as 2.46 microfarad. These problems are easy compared to LC oscillator problems. So, but this may be asked for 5 marks problems, but not only one problem, in 5 marks there will be 2 problem series. One from this Schall oscillator, another from the next oscillator, main bridge oscillator that we are going to cover today. So, maybe if they give oscillator problem, it will be easy, so maybe ask 2 problems may be asked in the 5 marks. Take the next problem. The frequency of the phase shift oscillator, third problem. Frequency of the phase shift oscillator is 78 Hz. If the value of capacitance is 220 nanofarad, calculate the value of resistance. Value of resistor solution here. Capacitor and frequency are given, so you have to find out the value of resistance. F is equal to 2 pi into root 6 RC. R is equal to 1 by 2 pi root 6 F into C. R is equal to 2 into 3.142 into root 6. F is 78, C is 220 nano, in the sense 10 to the power of minus 9. So R value you are going to get as 3.785 kilo ohm. Okay, this kind of problems will be asked. Excuse me. Okay students, let us continue with the next oscillator, that is Wain bridge oscillator. Okay, so in Wain bridge oscillator, in the feedback path we have connected a bridge circuit. So that circuit is called as lead-lag circuit. So this R1C1 is series along with R2C2 in parallel are connected to the two arms of the bridge and connected to the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. Here also we are going to use the operational amplifier as a amplification device. But the feedback network is connected to the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp here. So should be note that point, because while calculating the gain, we have to calculate the gain of the non-inverting amplifier. Here, going to study the Wheatstone bridge, the next coming chapters of physics, I feel. In that, the bridge, this bridge can be written as, let me write this. Actually, this circuit can be written as, if I RF is connected from here to here, that can be connected here RF, and this line is connected to RI or R4, this is R3, and if we connect like this, this acts as a bridge circuit. R1, R2, R3 by R. So, in bridge circuit, it will be like R1, R2 is equal to R3 by R4. If then we can tell bridge is balanced. Okay, when the bridge is balanced only, we get the conditions for oscillations here. So, here I have in the bridge R1C1 is a series RC network is connected to the one arm, and for the adjacent arm R2C2 parallel combination is connected, and remaining two arms we have connected here as an RF, which is a feedback path,
for the op amp and Ri is the input resistance for the op amp. So this Rf and Ri acts as R3 and R4 for this bridge, which also gives the gain stability for the operational amplifier. Okay, you know that Rf by feedback is connected in our op amp and all. So we'll study this circuit separately here. That is called as lead lag network. Why it is called a lead lag network? In the sense, at some frequencies, see, at low frequencies, this C1 acts as an open circuit. For when a frequency decreases, XC, that is equal to 1/2πfC. So XC increases. For low frequency signals, this C1 acts as an open circuit and will not allow any voltage, any signal inside. So it blocks the low frequency signals and acts as a high pass filter. Okay, at high frequencies, this C2 acts as a short circuit and it is connected in parallel to the output. When C2 acts as a short circuit, the output will be again zero. No output will be produced at high frequencies given. So for low frequencies, C1 acts as an open circuit and no output will be zero. At high frequencies, C2 acts as a short circuit which is connected in parallel to the output circuit, so output will be zero. So at some frequency in between some intermediate frequency, the output will be maximum. That time XC is equal to R and this point is called as resonant frequency or point of resonance. Okay, at that time XC is equal to R and the frequency, that is equal to F, is equal to 1 by the actual frequency formula is 1/2π√ R1 C1 R2 C2. When R1 is equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2, then F is equal to 1/2π RC. So at low frequency, the phase angle is positive and it acts as a lead network. Output voltage leads the input voltage. Whereas at low frequencies, at high frequencies, the output voltage lags the input voltage. It acts as a lag network. So that means at 0 degree, it acts as a when output voltage leads the input voltage, and when output and input will be in same phase, that means 0 degree phase shift obtained when R1 is equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2, and this is the condition for sustained oscillations. The output voltage should be in phase with the input voltage, that is obtained because at low frequency it acts as a lead network. Phase angle is leading, output phase is leading, whereas at high frequencies the output phase is lagging. So at some particular frequency between these two, we'll get the output. Output will be in phase with the input voltage. That is, the phase shift between the output and input voltage will be 0 degree, and that is the condition for oscillations. That is obtained when R1 is equal to R2, C1 is equal to C2, and F is equal to 2π RC. So we can set the values of this R1 and C1 in such a way. We can set the desired frequency by setting the values of R1 and C2 of our desired one. So this is a lead lag network. Why it is called a lead lag network? In the sense, because at some frequencies the output is leading and at some frequencies output is lagging. So at one particular frequency, that is resonant frequency, that is set by setting the values of R1 and C2. That is, R1 is equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2. Then we get a desired frequency value. At that time, the output voltage will be maximum. If you draw the frequency response curve, it will be like this. See, for low pass filter, it will be frequency response will be like this. At high frequencies, it will be like this. So at it will not allow any low frequency signals and also high frequency signal. It will be allowing only one frequency, that is resonant frequency, and that is equal to 2 pi RC. And at that frequency, at that frequency, the phase shift between the input and output will be 0 degree. So this is the condition for oscillations. That is obtained by the lead lag network, which is connected to the non-inverting terminal of the op amp with a as a feedback network. That is between the output and the non-inverting input of the op amp, the RC lead lag network is connected, which is going to produce a 0 degree phase shift. So here the condition for bridge should be balanced, in the sense R1 divided by R2 is equal to, here in this particular circuit, it will be R3 by R4 is equal to R1 by R2 plus C1 by C2. This was the condition for Wheatstone bridge. So we know that to get the 0 degree phase shift, R1 is equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2. Therefore, R3 divided by R4 will be equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. The gain of the amplifier, operational amplifier, should be equal to, the ratio of the R3 by R4 is 2. What will be the gain of the amplifier? It's a non-inverting amplifier, that is 1 by R3 by R4, then 1 plus 2, that is the gain of the amplifier should be set to 3. And what would be the feedback factor? Feedback factor will be 1 by 3. Then we get A beta is equal to 1. If this condition is satisfied, already this RC lead lag network is providing 0 degree phase shift. And by setting the R3 by R2 ratio as 2, then we will get the sustained oscillations at the output. This is the very simplest oscillator circuit that can be implemented in so many circuits. Okay. Okay. Let's look into the advantages of RC oscillators. They do not require inductors. It's a main advantage, because when you use an inductor, the circuit complexity will be high. And they produce oscillations in the audio frequency range. That is one of the advantage. And frequency stability is good in RC oscillators. And circuit is compact and less expensive, because inductors are not used. The circuit will be compact. Very low value capacitors can be used. And expensive. It is a low cost. Disadvantages. It is difficult to change the values of all the resistors and capacitors. In phase shift oscillators, we are going to use the 3 resistors and 3 capacitors, right? And in non-inverting oscillators, again 4 resistors and 2 capacitors. So we have, every time when you need to change the frequency, different frequencies, you need to change the values of all the resistors and capacitors. That is a difficult thing, and not easy to start the oscillation, because your feedback is low and cannot generate high frequencies. Okay, and these components, the RC components, are temperature dependent and the frequency will not be stable. And one more thing, you may be asked to write the advantages of RC oscillators over LC oscillators. You can take these advantages, because their inductors are used, circuit will be bulky and expensive, you can write. Here, inductors are not used. And these RC oscillators are used in audio frequency generators. And in low frequency applications, both are same, in audio frequency generators. And that completes the RC oscillators. In LC oscillators, we have studied 2 oscillators. In RC oscillators, we have studied 2 oscillators and their advantages and applications. Okay. In the next session, we are going to discuss the crystal oscillator.
And any doubts in these concepts, please text me. Thank you.